letter to an editor with the format. I hope that was very clear to you all. Now, moving over to the second part, that is placing an order. In today's world, when we all are going on for online shopping and all, so let's see how do I write a letter for placing an order. So let's start with the format. As I said, you have to start from near to the margin on your left hand side. This sender's address. Then comes the date. After that, it will be the receiver's address. Then comes the salutation. After that comes the subject. Then the body or the content. Now, since this is placing an order, so there should be few points which should be included in this. So let's see what all those points are. First will be reference to quotation, dated. Next will be list of items to be ordered. After that, the next will be expected delivery date. The next will be mode of payment, and after this will be condition of items. Deliver and as per requirement. Last will be complimentary clause. After that will be the name of a person. Last will be designation of the person who is writing this order letter. Now let's see once again. Sender's address, it will be the person who is writing the letter or who is placing an order. Here you need not include the name of the sender. After that will be the date, and again the pattern will be same. This way, right? After that comes the receiver's address, where you are going to write the address of the company from where you are placing, you are asking for your order or placing your order. That will come. Now when you are placing an order, remember one thing, that the address should be clearly written, should be mentioned properly with proper pin code and all, because if you fail to mention clear address, this may result in not delivering of your order. Right? So for that we should be very careful when writing the address. Next will be the salutation. After that will come the subject, where we are going to include for what you are placing an order. Next is the body or the content. Now this body or the content should include these following points, because this is a letter for placing an order. So it will be reference to quotation dated. Now what is reference to quotation dated? This will be like, suppose before placing an order I had a telephonic conversation with the person. So I would be mentioning here that as the telephonic conversation we had yesterday, or maybe the date whenever you had, I would like to place my order. That is how it will go. Next is the list of the items to be ordered. You have to mention the list in a proper way and very neatly and clearly, so that the person is clear of your order, what you need. Next is expected delivery date. So by which date you need your order to be delivered to you, that has to be clearly mentioned. And with this you will also mention one point, that if the order fails to be delivered on particular time or date, then it will stand as a cancelled order. You are not going to accept it after the date prescribed. Next we will be talking about mode of payment. How are you going to make the payment for the order that you have given? It can be a check, it can be cash, or it can be an online transaction. So be very specific and clear about this point also. Next is condition of items delivered and as per required. So sometimes it happens that the items, when they reach to us, they are in a damaged state, maybe due to not packing properly or something of that sort. So here, to be on the safer side, what to do? You first only tell the person that the item should be packed properly and sent, and when you receive the item, it should be in a good condition. If it is in a damaged condition, you will not be accepting the order, and it should be as per the requirement. Nothing should be misplaced or missing here from the order. So this is how you go with condition of items delivered and as per requirement. Next is the complimentary clause. Here again the same thing, yours faithfully or sincerely or obediently will come. And remember this very clearly, it should be Y will be capital, there will be no inverted comma, apostrophe before S, and F should also be in a small alphabet. After that will be the name of the person who is sending or who is placing an order, and then the designation of that person. Right? So this is what it has to be like this. So when I will write my letter, how exactly it will come out to be? Now suppose I am somebody who wants to place an order for my school. I want to place an order of books. Right? So how do I go? So I write name of my school, maybe Rohila Public School. Meerut. Then the date. Date can be anything. Suppose say 2020. After that will come the receiver's address. So because I am placing an order for my books, so it can be the manager. Vishal Book Mart. New Delhi. Whatever the pin code is. Then comes the sanitation. So respected sir. After that comes the subject. So in the subject you can write placing an order for books. Then body. So here you can go as per the things. This way you can write the order. After that comes the complementary clause. So here it can be yours faithfully, name of a person, suppose say Ram, and the designation. It can be the librarian of the school. So you can write your designation as librarian, right? So this is how the format will look when you are writing the letter. I hope this is very clear to you all. So see you in the next video with the next part of the letter. Thank you.